This silicon oil bubble is about to be popped. As air escapes, the bubble collapses and wrinkles form around its edges. This process is driven by gravity acting on the thin film, or so scientists thought. Now, a new study proposes to upend this traditional understanding of how bubbles in viscous fluids collapse. By better understanding how bubbles burst, scientists can control their presence or absence, which may be useful in a number of industries. For example, in applications like spray painting, it's best to minimize bubbles. If you're making ice cream, on the other hand, it's better to maximize air bubbles to make it soft and scoopable, says James Bird, who led the recent study. Bird began to question how viscous bubbles collapse more than a decade ago. He reasoned that if gravity were the main force behind a bubble's collapse, then flipping it upside down should make the popped film deflate towards the ground. Instead, what happened is that the upside-down bubble collapses in the same inward manner as if it were upright. So Bird and his co-authors hypothesized that another force was responsible for viscous bubble collapse: surface tension. Yet investigating this theory wasn't easy.
A challenging part is visualizing it. To get the light just the right way that you can see wrinkles in what otherwise would be kind of, it's a transparent film.
The authors estimate that they watched thousands of silicon bubbles of varying viscosities pop to collect enough data to measure how fast the bubbles collapsed. They found that the speed of collapse depended on viscosity and capillary forces, allowing them to confirm that surface tension was indeed the driving force behind the bubble's collapse. The team also investigated why the films wrinkle as they collapse, which aside from its eye-catching appearance, has practical implications. These wrinkles can trap air and cause more bubbles to form. Next, Bird says they plan to study how more complex mixtures of fluids behave, so they can better understand bubbles in the real world.